Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Her Royal Highness Raja Sophia, Raja Zarit Sophia, Raja Zarit Sophia Binti Al Marhum Sultan Idris Shah. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Assalamu alaikum, good morning. It is a very special occasion and a privilege for us, for myself, our colleagues at IAIS Malaysia, to welcome Her Royal Highness, not only to grace this occasion, this event, but to make a special intellectual contribution to the life of this institute. We are honored to for her to choose us, IAIS Malaysia, to deliver a royal address entitled The Impact of Globalization on Contemporary Muslim Societies. IAIS Malaysia is a non-profit, non-governmental organization devoted to the advancement of research on Islam in contemporary issues of concern to Malaysia, the Muslim world, in our relations with other civilizations. We were inaugurated only in October 2008 with the initial support of the government of Malaysia. Our basic agenda is to promote the idea of civilizational renewal, Tajdeed Hadwari, through the 10 principles of civilizational Islam, Islam Hadwari. Included among these is faith in God and piety, a just and trustworthy government, balanced economic development, a robust approach to the development of knowledge, protection of the rights of minorities and women, and protection and preservation of the natural environment, among others. I believe now, as I did 3 years ago, when conceptualizing the research agenda for this institute, that the broader civilizational objectives of Islam should not be compromised in the way that are reflected in the Islamic fundamentalist discourse of recent decades. The language of fundamentalism remain focused on relatively minor issues, a mannerism, what people wear and what people eat. It was driven by ideology instead of paying attention to people's welfare, to good governance, to economic development. It remained focused on those issues. There was a need to open the scope in the horizon of that discourse. And with that challenging agenda, we started this institute. by looking at the broader civilizational objective of Islam, that contextualizes our effort with the challenges we face, challenges of modernity, globalization, responding, formulating meaningful responses to issues concerning Islam. And this is our objective, to make a contribution, especially through looking at the resources of Islam and the guidelines that we can relate to these challenges we are facing. We run a fairly active schedule of activities, of conferences and seminars, publications. Last year in 2009, We had more than 35 events, national and international seminars and conferences, and this year so far about 18 of them. And we also have publication programs, publishing monographs, occasional paper series, and we have a quarterly, international quarterly journal, Islam and Civilizational Renewal, that is produced and internationally distributed by Pluto Journals of London. We remain open to fresh currents and influences. We also feature in the broadsheet, television, mass media, in frequent interviews. This is a challenging agenda, and we are encouraged by the public support that we have received and enjoyed. And indeed, we do need the public support. I would like to record a special note of appreciation to Her Royal Highness Raja Zarit Sophia, Binte Al-Marhum Sultan Idris Shah, for granting us the privilege to deliver her royal address at IAIS Malaysia today. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you, Professor Kamali, for the welcoming remarks. Without further ado, I would like to invite Emeritus Professor Dato Dr. Osman bin Bakar to introduce today's Royal Guest of Honor, Her Royal Highness Raja Zarit Sophia binti Almarhum Sultan Idris Shah. Please welcome Professor Osman.